dwell in place in all generations. Before the mountains were brought forth, or even thou hast formed the earth and the world, even from everlasting to everlasting, thou art God. Thou turnest man to destruction and says, return, ye children of men. For 1,000 years in thy sight are but as yesterday when it is past, and as a watch in the night. Thou carriest them away as with a flood. They are as asleep in the morning. They are like grass which groweth up. In the morning it flourisheth and groweth up. In the evening it is cut down and withered. For we are consumed by thine anger, and by thy wrath are we troubled. Thou hast set our iniquities before thee, our secret sins in the light of thy countenance. For all our days are passed away in thy wrath. We spend our years as a tale that is told. The days of our years are 80 years and 10, and if by reason of strength they be 80 years, yet is their strength labor and sorrow. For it is soon cut off, and we fly away. Who knoweth the power of thine anger? Even according to thy fear, so is thy wrath. So teach us to number our days, that we may apply our hearts unto wisdom. Return, O Lord, how long? And let it repent thee concerning thy servants. O satisfy us early with thy mercy, that we may rejoice and be glad all our days. Make us glad according to the days wherein thou hast afflicted us, and the years wherein we have seen evil. Let thy work appear unto thy servants, and thy glory unto their children. And let the beauty of the Lord our God be upon us, and establish thou the work of our hands upon us, And 142. Leave God to order all thy ways.
Oh.
brothers and sisters, as I keep telling, and I will keep on saying it, I invent nothing. It's all in the text before you. And the first thing you can see said about Cornelius, he was a Roman officer who was a proselyte to the Jewish religion. So, which means this man was a pagan without any religion. He did not worship any god. And for the Romans, you know, for the Romans, especially for a soldier and a captain of over 100 people, what matters? It's not erudition. It's not knowledge. What matters for them is self-worship. What matters for them is power. Not power of God, but man's power. That's really what mattered for the Romans. But here he is, this Roman, in a Jewish land, came to adopt, to embrace the Jewish religion. That's what he said in verse 1. There was a certain man in Caesarea called Cornelius, a centurion of the band called the Italian band. So first, he was a religious man. From paganism, he now adopted the religion of the Jews. And the second thing, I just glanced them very quickly because we want to draw some applications for ourselves later. And the second thing, verse 2, it says that he was a devout man. He was devout. He was godly. He was pious with deep convictions and great convictions. He was sincere. And this is something really we have to draw our attention on. There are many people in our world, they are sincere. They pray. They worship. They give alms. They do great things. They are sincere. But as you know the saying, you can be sincere and be sincerely wrong. So sincerity is not a warrant of having access to God. So first, Cornelius was a religious man. Second, he was devout. He was sincere. He was pious. He was godly. And the third thing I want to put before you, still in verse 2, he was a man who feared God. He feared God. And many times we ask people, why are you a Christian? And they say, oh, I fear God. But you see, this man feared God, but that was God has no two kinds of people. Only one. One people. That's his chosen people. In the church of Jesus Christ, where everyone who has trusted, repented from his sins, and put his faith on the shed blood of the Lord Jesus Christ, have the remission of his sins. And that's very important. So, we don't need a vision. We don't need an angel to speak to us. Why? Because now we have all the counsel of God. Everything we need to know about how to find the Lord. Cornelius need the presence of that vision. He need the coming of Peter. But we don't need anything of such, because now we have the whole counsel of God. The canon of the Bible is closed, and we have everything we need. We have the full counsel of God. We have the Bible, and Bible is sufficient in all things that pertain to faith and practice. So that was the seventh one. The eighth one, Cornelius was called a just man. He was a just man. Look at it in verse 22. A just man with a good report. He had a good report in verse 22. And they said, the servants of Cornelius said, Cornelius, the centurion, a just man, and one that feared God, and of good report among all the nation of the Jews. You see? So he was a man of good report, a just man. He was right in his own right. But now, to be right before God, nobody's right, Bible says. But to be right before God, we must receive the righteousness of the Lord Jesus Christ, because he is the righteous one. Now the next one, the ninth one, and this is another amazing one. Cornelius was a humble man. Oh, my dear friends, can I draw your attention? For anyone to be saved, you need to be a humble person. Why? Because deep down in us, we are all proud people. Proud. Full of ourselves. But in verse 25, you can see that when Cornelius came before Peter, he had to kneel down. He had to bow down before Peter. Of course, Peter didn't like it. It's not that Peter wanted to be praised or worshipped by anyone, but it is a way of respect. It is a way of respect. But remember, who is Cornelius? This is a centurion, a man who has in charge over 100 soldiers. But look at him now, bowing down before a fisherman. And I can only say, I have seen so many testimonies. And I have heard so many testimonies. Here is a proud person who thinks the world is the center of the world. But he comes, God crushes him down, and he sees that he is nothing. And he is humbled to the dust. And he cries to God to save him. My dear friends, no power can do that in this world. It must be the power of the Holy Spirit. And in verse 25, you can see that Cornelius fell down at his feet and worshipped him. Are you a humble person? Am I a humble person when it comes to salvation? You see, all these things are crucial for us. They are good qualities, but soldier under his command. But now Peter will speak to him. You see, we believe in instrumentality. God can save. He can save. He has power to save. But he always saves through instrumentality. And Peter was sent as the instrument by which Cornelius will hear great things about the Lord Jesus Christ. And I have listed five of them. Five things Cornelius is going to say about the Lord Jesus Christ to Cornelius, which will bring him to salvation. And the first one, told him openly, not to all people, verse 41, but unto witnesses chosen before of God, even to us who did eat and drink with him after he rose from the dead.
Again, I say to Muslims, when Muhammad received the revelation, who were the witnesses?
None.
But with Christ, his resurrection, his ascension, 500 witnesses, my dear friend, 500 witnesses were there. And Peter and the 12, they touched him, they ate with him, they walked with him, and they saw him when he was risen from the dead. And the 14th, Cornelius will hear, is that verse 42, Christ was ordained to be the judge of the world, the dead and the living. Oh, my dear friends, if you know the Lord Jesus Christ, when you shall stand before him to be judged. Romans 8 verse 1 says, no more condemnation. But remember, Christ is going to be the judge of the dead and the living. Everyone will appear before him. But look, one last thing before I close. In verse 43, he gives, this is without exception. The gospel is inclusive and it excludes.